water is very scarce in Southern California. A lot of the water has to be imported in from very long distances. If we didn't have water, our life would be completely different than it is now. Some of the simple things that we do in the morning, such as take a shower, brush our teeth, have a cup of coffee, those simple things wouldn't be there. My name is Frank Walensky. I'm the Operations and Field Services Manager for the Vista Irrigation District. I'm responsible for making sure that water gets from its source to the customer's tap. Our customers expect, you know, when they turn on the tap, that water's going to be there. It's going to be safe. It's going to be potable. And also, it's going to be there 24/7, 365. Currently, the Vista Irrigation District has two sources of water. We have our own local supply at Lake Henshaw. And the other we get from the State Water Project in Northern California, as well as the Colorado River. Over the years, the Vista Irrigation District has had to adapt to meet the ever-changing needs of a growing population within the community of Vista. The district currently serves a population of approximately 128,000 people. We have approximately 435 miles of pipeline, 12 water storage reservoirs, 17 different pressure zones. We monitor various pressure-reducing facilities, and we have approximately 30 remote sites that we monitor these through.
We use programmable automation controllers to bring data into a central location for viewing and for controlling purposes. The well locations throughout the ranch are very remote. They're subject to an enormous amount of heat in the summer times and freezing temperatures in the winter.
Managing all those remote sites that we have without an automation and control system would be near impossible. So we got our start with Opto 22 in the early 90s through our SCADA integrator, IDAC West.
IDAC West has been an integrator for Vista Irrigation District for almost as long as we've been in existence. The first system we put in almost 20 years ago was an older Opto 22 system, and they needed to upgrade that to the current Ethernet technology. So instead of deciding to do everything all at once, they figured out a layered approach to take some of the key sites and update that one at a time. And using the Opto 22 hardware, we were able to talk to the old sites and the new sites. And as we did each site, we moved it over to the new technology.
One of the advantages of Opto 22 products is they've always enabled backwards compatibility. You know, with the help of IDAC West, you know, we were able to phase all this process in, migrating through the various generations. This is something that over the years has saved the district money, and that's something we've been able to pass on to our ratepayers.
The Vista Irrigation System has systems out in the field that are very intelligent. If something breaks down, they decide what they're going to do out in the field. If there's a communications drop from one point to another that's a key, both points decide, based on the logic we've built in, what to do.
Distributed intelligence allows our remote sites to basically run autonomously.
If there's a disaster of some type, whether it's an earthquake or a major fire, and the distributed portion of the control goes down, as in the masters go down, the sites will continue working, and they'll still be able to fill the fire trucks so they can put out the fires and keep as much water going. And in some cases, if there's a break in the line, it will automatically stop to prevent the water from going out.
You know, it's our job to distribute water 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. To bring water to our customers today, we're leveraging technology to do that.